This video is sponsored by Audible. Hello everyone! Today I'll tell you about such a metal as vanadium. Vanadium is a transition metal that is located in the fifth group of the periodic table of chemical elements. One of the fascinating things is that in air vanadium gets covered with a beautiful film of vanadium oxides, which gives the metal a very beautiful multicolored look. Different colors can be seen due to the different thickness of the oxide film all around. Because of that, light in different areas is absorbed and reflected at different wavelengths. Pieces of vanadium look very beautifully. However, the oxide film on the vanadium surface can be dissolved with nitric acid, after which the silver surface of this metal can be seen. Density-wise, vanadium is quite light. This metal is very stable in air and does not react with sulfuric or hydrochloric acid. If the non-oxidized vanadium crystals are heated in air, they will be covered with an oxide film, also giving it a multicolored appearance. Vanadium is readily soluble in nitric acid, forming vanadial chloride that has a blue color and nitrogen dioxide. Over time, the reaction is accelerated due to the heating of the mixture and effervesces. Nitrogen dioxide, a very dangerous gas, starts to escape from the solution. However, the most interesting property of vanadium is that with its compounds it's possible to carry out the so-called chameleon reaction. For this reaction, let's take a little of ammonium vanadate, a substance used as a catalyst in organic synthesis. We'll add hydrochloric acid to ammonium vanadate, and due to this reaction, the so-called polyvanadate oxides are formed in the solution. By the way, vanadium oxide 5 is used as an effective catalyst in the production of sulfuric acid. Initially, the liquid in the test tube is yellow. To start the reaction, we'll add a few zinc granules into the test tube. The hydrogen evolution reaction begins, in which atomic hydrogen is formed that has the ability to efficiently give back an electron and restore other compounds. Over time, the color of the solution changes to blue due to hydrogen restoring vanadium to oxidation state plus 4. Further, the solution gradually acquires a green color due to the addition of one more electron by the vanadium atom. At the end, after some time, the solution becomes violet, since vanadium has taken all the electrons from the atomic hydrogen, while restoring itself to bivalent vanadium. I decided to conduct another experiment, where I would add an alkali or sodium hydroxide to the vanadium chloride. I was amazed by the result. It turned out to be some sort of cosmos within a test tube. Let me go, vanadium! It looks very fascinating with macro as well. Vanadium compounds are quite toxic, but there are organisms that are practically filled with vanadium, for example, fly agarics and from the sea life, shells. Scientists are still racking their heads as to why in these organisms there is so much vanadium-containing protein, amavadine. Nowadays, the metal vanadium is mainly used as a component of very strong steels. The addition of small amounts of vanadium to steel makes it much stronger and harder. Often from such steel, wrenches and surgical instruments are made. A big thanks to Audible for sponsoring that video and supporting my channel. Audible offers an unmatched array of content including audiobooks, original audio shows, news, comedy and much more. They're offering a 1 month free trial for all of my viewers, which you can get by going on audible.com/toysoy2. It takes me a real long time to make all my videos, and to keep me motivated I usually listen to some audiobooks. I just finished listening to Stuff Matters by Mike Medovnik, and I definitely recommend to checking it out. It's a very entertaining and informative talk on everyday objects and materials. If that kind of book isn't your profile, there are a lot of other books you can listen to, like Game of Thrones or even some science fiction. If you want help of my channel, you can sign up for your free trial at audible.com/toysoy2 and claim your free audiobook. Now you have learned a little bit more about one of the metals. If you want the series with the elements to continue, put some likes and subscribe to my channel to find a lot of more new and interesting.